Welcome, my crows.
Oh, goodness me.
Yeah, I can see like the like Netflix like sirens beginning to like the spoiler.
Anyone there?
Hello.
Hey. And we're here on set doing some stuff.
Doing some stuff.
These boys are a joy and I just love them. I love them.
Outfits, experience.
Yeah, Jack, you'd rock all them, wouldn't
accent.
You?
Queerness.
He feels like the mix of our characters.
Neckerchief.
I would say you.
Possibly. What is your star sign?
I am a Scorpio.
Sagittarius.
Yes.
And you know what that means?
I don't.
Lovey, lovey.
Realizing that this event could make their dreams come true. If something so wild like this has happened, then maybe they can be happy again and get the things that they think they really want, including Peter.
Who's the compliment about?
You!
Okay, it's not easy to assimilate, this is big words, I bet it's ready, assimilate into an established group whilst also remaining totally true to your wonderful self, but you did it seamlessly. I absolutely loved watching you work and make Wylan the brilliant 3D character that the fans are going to love. You also have the voice of an angel and face. That's very kind. Can I ask who it's from?
It's from Freddy.
I knew it! Who's the compliment about?
You!
Okay, can I ask who it's from?
It's from Freddy.
I knew it!
And there's bits of it.
Yeah, it's all over my hands.
Oh, see? Little Christmas treat.
What has been your favorite day on set?
There was this really good day when we were shooting in Shuhan where they brought alpacas to set. Yeah, and it was really exciting. And both Kit and Freddy are very, very tall. And they were stood either sides of me. And I was like, I just can't see the alpaca. I'm the only one in Shuhan who can't see the alpaca. And without even a word, both of them grabbed a leg and lifted me up so I could see the alpacas over everyone. That was my favorite day on set. That was my favorite day on set.
I am absolutely convinced that Kit has fake revolvers at home, so he just can keep twirling them.
Not wrong. You started strong.
We're going to play a game to see if any other Netflix characters are worthy of being our seventh crow.
Oh!
Fair play.
Boring.
How old are you?
I'm 26. Yeah.
Are you able to get alcoholic drinks when you want to buy some?
Nowadays, I guess if I wanted to.
That was something that meant a lot to me. Theatre's a huge part of my life, and anything that sort of can help gain support for the arts in that way, I think is amazing. Also, what a beautiful cat.
So the opera world, I found quite intimidating.
I'm a heart full of love.
He was never mine.
A heart full of you.
Why with red can then I knew.
According to Book Jesper's wiki page, what is his main occupation aside from sharpshooter? A, second in command of the crows. B, advisor and reading assistant to Wylan. C, professional gambler. Or D, secret Grisha. It is B, advisor and reading assistant.
Oh, that's very sweet. I mean, they're all valid.
Yeah,
they're all valid,
true.
Yeah.
The fans are not going to pass up a Wesper, a chance of that.
This is true.
Neither am I.
Yeah.
And I remember reading the description of this character, and it contains some parts of the book, and there's a description about Wylan in the books that Leigh Bardugo wrote, which is he seems like a silk-eared puppy in a room full of fighting dogs. And I was like, that's such a great description of someone.
Bit of a nervous explosives expert. So that's Whalen.
Kaz's crows or Sturman's crew?
There is one right answer.
There is one right answer. Absolutely. Sturmhorn's crew would put up a very valiant fight. Mm-hmm. It would be really good.
Correct.
But that is the weakness. Because his crows don't have to be valiant or good or correct.
Wow.
There would be sneaky underground backdoor fighting happening.
You heard it here first. Our biggest weakness is that we're too good.
Valiant.
Yeah.
You are so clever.
In the card it says, "Dear Miriam, have an elephant to Christmas. Love, Jack."
Happy Christmas, Miriam.
And I have a ukulele, as I'm sure many people have seen on my Instagram.
And I have a big ukulele, which I'm learning, by the way. So.
Novices.
No, novices at all.
So, I think it's number one as well. The wrapping looks very protective, like it would really look after a cake.
That plastic is way too good. It's like overly plasticky.
He does have fantastic hair.
Yeah.
Oh, and I think that is a thing to consider.
I don't know.
It's a prerequisite for being a crow.
He does have fantastic hair.
Yeah.
Oh, and I think that is a thing to consider.
I don't know.
It's a prerequisite for being a crow.
Thank you for having me.
And it's a big month. It's a Jack Wolf month. I mean, the Magic Flute, I mean, season two of Shadow and Bone. I mean, there's a lot happening right now.
I'm very grateful. It's been a bit wild, but very exciting.
It's kind of like, does it feel like you're on a roller coaster that you can't get off, basically?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, everything feels like that to me, to be honest.
I did a lot of growing up over the time of shooting anyway. You know, it was my first time shooting a film. So I felt like a complete infant there. I felt like I didn't know anything.
Especially at the beginning of the shoot, I was so just intimidated by the vastness of the job. I feel like I was starting and far too, I think, self-conscious to think about that. As the shoot went on and I was beginning to sort of gain a little bit more confidence, I was able to sort of look outwardly and really sort of respond to that.
Yes.
What is Matthias's weapon of choice in the Netflix adaptation according to his wiki page?
Ooh.
A, bow and arrows. B, Ebola. C, a sword. Or D, a staff.
So not fooling anyone, is that really you playing the piano in the film?
It is. That is me playing the piano in the film.
Actually, funnily enough, because I played the piano when I was growing up. And so the scene where we sing that song is actually just a moment between Tim and Sophie, just sort of playing on the piano and having a sing together. And ironically, that's something that I did growing up, you know, instead of going to PE sometimes, I'd hide in the music rooms and play the piano and sing songs with my friends. And like, so that shooting that scene actually really felt like home to me.
Yeah, I played the piano for a really long time. In fact, they were very, very kind to let me write a little piece that Whalen plays in the series. It's in episode 3 that I had the best weekend, like coming up with this little sort of 30-second bit.
Just sit around and wait for you. No, I can do that. There's no turning back.
So to be in the room, sort of taking it apart and working on it, it's just been like real magic.
Very clearly millennial Instagram bios I've ever seen, which is because I was like, oh, I wonder how old Jack is. And I went and looked, I was like, well, I can tell he's a millennial alone because of that Instagram.
Oh yeah, he's seen a little vampire.
That was 13 weeks ago and it has no likes.
Dang it, baby, dang it.
Yeah, I play a character called Peter Duchene, and you get to sing some really beautiful songs.
Yeah.
By Mark Tyler's written. I am so grateful because he's written these beautiful, beautiful melodies. That's some competition that I don't know if Whalen would be into. They'd either like duet really well or there'd be a lot of jealousy flying around.
That's amazing to hear, especially since he's always playing villains. It's nice to hear.
Yeah, I know. It's so funny, isn't it? Yeah.
I play lots of bullies. It seems.
Which is weird.
Scammed. I hope neither of us. Too trusting.
I think, yeah, too trusting.
Kit got it right. It's
Josh!
It was.
Richard.
Richard.
That was my glasses.
Really?
Sorry.
Well, a really special thing for me was that the Bavaria Film Studios, where we shot the film, is also where they shot the Neverending Story.
Can you imagine how I felt cried. When I found out that news? Because I was already overwhelmed to begin with. I was already overwhelmed. And then that, I could have fainted. I got to meet Falcor, the luck dragon.
I would have died. I would have just died.
I think I did. I don't think I exist, to be honest. Ever since then, it's just been a ghost.
Oh my gosh, that's so nice.
So I'm like, I need sugar and my body's going here.
Only on Netflix.
Jack, question off the top of my head here. Yeah. What was your first day on set like?
My first day of set, I was so excited and so terrified. I had to sort of be like pulled out of the trailer by the other crows.
I, as an actor, as a person, like I'm sure there are loads of us out there, approach things with fear first. And I think it's that thing of not wanting people to know that you're scared.
And you might think you remember me, but you'd be mistaken because I wasn't in season one. But I am in season two.
Lucky us.
Jack's threatened.
Time travel not good enough for you.
I think something really special about the film is that it brings classical music and Mozart to a modern audience.
I hope the people who have been waiting for it, that we've done them proud and that they're able to see a production that they feel is representative of what they love about the show, but also helps them discover new things, new parts of the show, things they might not have thought about before.
No, just thank you so much for coming and watching. We've had loads of fun putting it together. And also, like, terror, it's really nerve-wracking.
Bye!
Happy Friday!
We love
Bye.
You! How the hell do you...
Callahan's first con. Jack...
I'm gonna wind up.
know what they say about the room?
Oh, look at this. Hilarious. Look at that.